Well, we wrapped up the month of November with melting snow and above normal high temperatures for a change. But as we move into December, the snow is coming back and so is the colder weather. Here's a look at your 7-day temperature trend. We're going to see highs in the mid-30s tomorrow, lower 30s for Sunday and Monday, and then dropping down into the lower and mid-20s for Tuesday and Wednesday. Right now, we have temperatures that are mainly in the lower half of the 30s, although it's 29 degrees in Sturgeon Bay, and we're also looking at 29 in Anigo. In Green Bay, with overcast conditions, the temperature is 34. In Appleton, we're also looking at cloudy skies. It's a little bit cooler, coming in at 30, with southwest winds at around 5 miles per hour. High pressure, our main weather maker today, the calm before the storm, but now the storm is headed our way for this upcoming weekend. You can see it developing now across the panhandle of Texas and Oklahoma. Really not a whole lot going on just yet, but you can see the Gulf moisture now working north across parts of Kansas and Nebraska. It's primarily rain right now, but it's going to be switching over to some snow later on tonight. It looks like the heaviest snow from the storm will fall to our south and west, where over a foot is possible. That's where we have winter storm warnings. But then that area of snow is going to be tracking east northeast into Wisconsin as we head into tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow night, and Sunday. Right now, we do not have any winter weather advisories in place, but I am expecting them to be issued either later tonight or tomorrow morning. Skycast shows cloudy skies throughout the night, quiet weather tomorrow morning. Here comes the storm as we move through tomorrow afternoon with a mixture of some snow, sleet, and rain that will then continue as we head deeper into the evening. Tomorrow night, a mixture of some light snow and light rain and some light sleet before everything starts to go back over to snow as we head into Sunday morning, and then we'll see snow continue for much of Sunday. Now, this is a very tricky forecast. We're looking at snow, sleet, and rain across the area. Temperatures will be in the lower to mid-30s when this precipitation is falling, and a 1 to 2 degree difference can have a huge impact on how much snow you see outside in your backyard. More mixing equals less snow. Here's what the computer forecast models are showing to kind of give you an example of this. We have less than an inch showing up on the American computer forecast model, the GFS. Meanwhile, the NAM is showing about 8 inches of snow here for the Fox Valley. Right now, I'm going with the Skycast model, which shows about 1 to 3 inches across the area by tomorrow evening. A little bit of a lull as we start to mix tomorrow night into very early Sunday, and then it looks like another 1 to 2, maybe 3 inches as we head through Sunday. I'm thinking 3 to 6 inches from roughly Green Bay north and west. Lesser totals are likely to the south and east, but once again, this could shift a little bit farther south or north depending on where that rain-snow line sets up tomorrow night. The main story here is more snow northwest, more rain south and east. In between, we'll have that messy mixture with some tricky traveling for sure. At Lambeau Field, looks like it's going to be snowing. Kickoff temperatures will be in the lower 30s with gusty northeast winds. So tonight, mostly cloudy with some fog, upper 20s to lower 30s. Tomorrow, a mix developing and windy. High temperatures will be in the mid-30s. If you're going to check out the Festival of Lights tomorrow evening at Lambeau Field, look for rain and or snow and gusty winds. Temperatures will be in the mid-30s. I will be hosting the countdown to turning on the lights right around 6:30 to 6:45. So come on down. Snow on Sunday and windy, 33 degrees. Windy and colder on Monday into Tuesday, maybe a flurry. High temperature is only in the lower to mid-20s. A brief warm-up on Thursday with the chance for some light snow. And then even colder weather comes in on Friday with highs in the teens to around 20 degrees. This forecast is not set in stone, Ryan. Tune back tonight. I'll have an update at 10 o'clock, and Gino Recchia will be in tomorrow with the latest and greatest as far as the snow totals are concerned.
So are you ready to bundle up tomorrow night?
I will be bundled up for sure. I hope it's just snowing like crazy outside.
Really?
That'd be a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a blast. Good Packer game, too, this Sunday.
Yes.
Thanks, Cameron. All right, well, coming up next, you're on NBC 26 tonight at 5. A massive earthquake striking Alaska and causing a tsunami warning. More details coming up next. Welcome back. In Anchorage, Alaska, homes and businesses are damaged, roads have been buckled and collapsed, and there is even a tsunami warning for parts of Alaska coastline after a major earthquake struck this morning. Here's NBC 26's Chris Pallone in Alaska reporting.
It happened around 8:30 local time. The ground in Anchorage, Alaska started rumbling.
We do have a massive earthquake that was felt earlier.